Okay, we are here at the job site, and we are setting this thing in place so that we can take a level measurement here. So this guy is level. Have to prop it up that much to get it level. Now we need to scribe the base so that it matches that space there with our dividers. And come over here and let's figure out what space this is. So I'm going to go ahead and do this, and first I'm going to make sure it's plumb to front to back. Okay, I've had to pull that away quite a bit to get that plumb. You can see that guy's leaning back quite a bit, so I have to move this thing out pretty good on the wall. Okay, so I've got my center line right there, and I've got this thing level, plumb, level, and ready to go. Got my spacer there, and I need to just, now that I've got this, I kind of need to just firmly hold this guy while I do my scribing. Okay, you can see I've got it scribed all the way around the base. So, just using my dividers like this. Like that. Right in the line. And this distance I got from the biggest distance over there. I just measured it to keep my shims in place. I taped them to the wall, keeping in reference to that center point there. Now once these bottoms are trimmed, I'm going to then scribe the whole perimeter. And that perimeter is going to be removed by nearly that, not quite, but probably about 3/4 of an inch. All right, so right now I'm going to take this down. Take this whole thing down, and I'm gonna trim it. Okay, so we are good. We are level. It's tight. Tight. So now what we have to do is go around and scribe how much we want to remove from this guy. So if we look at this distance, and we know that there's going to be a 7/8 inch piece back here. So we know that we can leave a space, a decent space. Boy, that is just barely enough. Yeah, this is a serious thing. A step wall. So a nice grab, try to keep it level as much as you can. Just go up, this wall's a little bumpy. Now that we switch hands, now we go across. see. Light disappears there. That's the maximum. And then it regains right here. You can see that. A little bit right there.
Thank you.
Okay, so I just got done scribing this. And that's just one time of scribing it. I haven't touched it up at all, but man, that is really good. Really good. That is awesome. It doesn't get any better than that. Wow. Look at that, man. Sometimes I amaze myself. This wall is pretty jacked. Pretty jacked up. Crown, cutting up above the crown with the jigsaw, that's a real pain in the ass, you know. Very hard to do. So, marks here. We're gonna make some marks for the cleats. We'll do that right now. Alright, so, we just take the pencil and I'm just gonna make a mark. This mark is obviously going to be covered with the caulking and the painting and all that stuff. Alright, now we're going to come over here. Same thing. The line. All the way. This one too.
This is representing the top, and then this is where the cleat's gonna go. So this is our top of the cleat going all the way across, and then here, same thing goes. This line, this inside line represents the actual leg. This is where the cleat's gonna go, so right up to this line, and it's gonna go over and actually overhang. I think I'm gonna put a little skinny one here. The problem is that you can never get solid wood in this areas, but I brought some little ones, so I'll put some construction adhesive and just hit it right here as well as right here. So I'm gonna put those on right now. All right, I marked the center of this board. Thank you. guys on here. This is hitting framing right there. And it's glued. So that's real strong. This also had framing, but I put screws in. This is very strong.
So you can see my black line that'll be covered with the caulking or paint when they paint this. That's my pencil line, see? That'll all be covered.